हेलो एवरीवन चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम टॉपिक ऑफ एडजेक्टिव एंड इट्स काइंड्स। अर्लियर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट एडजेक्टिव डेफिनेशन, इट्स एग्जांपल्स एंड टू काइंड्स, दैट इज एडजेक्टिव ऑफ क्वालिटी एंड एडजेक्टिव ऑफ क्वांटिटी। नाउ द रेस्ट ऑफ द काइंड्स वी विल स्टडी टुडे, सो लेट्स बिगिन। Okay, next kind of adjectives are adjective of number. Earlier we have read about adjective of quantity. Adjective of quantity and adjective of number, they are quite similar. Only the difference is that adjective of quantity refers to how much and adjective of number refers to how many. How much means what is the amount or quantity, and how many means what is the number. Okay, so definition of this is those adjectives which indicates how many persons or things are there or in what order any of them stands are called adjectives of number. Okay, understood? Adjective of number refers to how many persons or things are there or in what order they stands. Okay, like first, second, third, fourth, all these are also adjective of number. They answer the question of how many, whereas adjective of quantity, they answer the question how much. Okay, now can you make out the difference? That adjective of number answer the question of how much and adjective of number, they answer the question of how many. Many means what is the number. Okay, for example, he had 5 chocolates in his hand. 5, you can say 5 is a number. Okay, so 5 is adjective of number here. He got 7 marks. 7 is also a number. So 7 is a adjective of number. Then many women were there. Many refers to a certain amount, certain number of women which were there. So many can be any number. Okay, so many here is the adjective of number. Some men were rich in that village. Some also here refers to number of men which were rich in that village. So some can be any number. Several men came to see the lion. This also refers to a certain number of men. So several also is the adjective of number. So in all these examples, you can see these words refers to the number of person or things. That is why the words in red color, they indicate adjective of number. Now next comes demonstrative adjectives. Demonstrative adjectives, those adjectives which point out which persons or things are meant are called demonstrative adjective. Okay, those adjective which points to a certain person or things means to point to a particular person or thing is called demonstrative. How we point to a person or thing? This, with this, or that. This is used when the person or anything which we are pointing is close to us. We point to that person or thing with this. And when that person or thing is far away from us, then we point it to that. So they answer the question of which. Okay. Now here is a note. This and that are used with singular nouns. When the nouns are singular, we use this and that. This for the close to us and that for which are far from us. And these and those are used with plural nouns. Same concept in these and those. These are used when the things or person or any noun is close to us. And those are used when it is far from us. And they are used with plural nouns. Okay, now for example, this is my bottle. So you are pointing to the bottle that this is my bottle. So this here is the demonstrative adjective. I like those mangoes. So here those is demonstrative adjective because you are pointing to those mangoes. Those means the mangoes are far from you. It is not close to you. So you refers to the mangoes with those. That horse is yours. So that here is the demonstrative adjective. I want these books. These here is the demonstrative adjective. And I hate such persons. Such means you are pointing to some persons which you hate. So such persons is such is the demonstrative adjective here. So it's clear that those adjective which points out to persons or things which are meant for, they are called demonstrative adjectives. Now next is the interrogative adjective. Now next is interrogative adjectives. Those adjectives which are used with nouns to ask a question. Okay, the word interrogative itself indicates asking question only. In all the topics we have learned about interrogative adjectives, interrogative words, and interrogative simply means asking question only. So those adjectives which are used with nouns to ask the questions, such adjectives are called interrogative adjectives. For example, what pictures have you seen? So pictures are noun here and we are asking that what pictures have you seen. So what here is the interrogative adjective. Second is, which house is yours? So in this, house is the noun here and we are asking which house. We are pointing to the house, that which house is yours. We are asking the question. So which is the interrogative adjective again. Then which boy did this? Boy is the noun here and we are asking that which boy did this. So which again is the interrogative. Then whose book is this? Book is the noun here and we are asking that whose book is this. So whose here is again interrogative adjectives. So interrogative adjectives are used to ask the questions. Now next is the possessive adjectives. Possessive adjectives. I have forgot to mention it in the chart which I have given on the second slide in the previous video. I forgot to mention it, but it is also one of the kind of adjectives, that is possessive adjectives. So what are possessive adjectives? Those adjectives which shows any possession are called possessive adjectives. So what is possession? Possession means a thing which belongs to someone. Anything which belongs to someone, that is called the possession. Like this purse is mine. Okay, so this purse belong to mine. This is my purse, you can say. So that thing belongs to whom? So that is called possession. That a particular thing is belonging to whom? That is called possession in simple meaning. So these adjectives are used to show possession, like my, yours, is, his, her, its, are used if the possessor is singular. If the possessor is singular person, single person, then what are the adjectives which are used? My refers to single. Yours also is single. His means any boy, and her means any girl, and its is used for things and animals. Okay, so if the possessor is singular, then we use my, yours, his, her, and its. Now if the possessor is plural, what are the words we use? What are the adjectives? Our, your, and their are used if the possessor is plural. So if the possessor is plural, we use our, your and their. Our is used in first person, your is used in second person and their is used in third person plural. For example, this is her purse. In this, her is the possessive adjective because it is showing the possession of the purse, that this purse belongs to her. So this is her purse, means it is a purse of any some girl. Her is used for girls, so her is used because in this sentence her is the possessive adjective. In second one, where is your book? We are asking that where is your book. Your is the second person singular. So your here is the possessive adjective, that where is your book, that this book belongs to you. So what is your where is your book. So your here is the possessive adjective. Now the trees are losing their leaves. So the leaves are of the trees. So trees are losing their leaves. So there is the possessive adjective. Meera is going with her brother. Meera is going with her brother. So her is the possessive adjective, that she is going with her brother. Her is showing the position, that brother is of Meera. We have our own car. So the car owns to us and we have our own car. So our is the possessive adjective here. So those adjectives which shows the possession of something, the thing belongs to whom, they shows this, then those adjectives are called possessive adjectives. Now I hope you have understood all the different kinds of adjectives clearly. Now you can go through it and you can note down in your copies if you want all the kinds of adjectives with the examples. In the next video, I will give you some exercises related to these adjective and its kinds. So you have to go through the topic and keep watching the videos and be update with your homework which we are giving you. Stay safe, stay home and bye.